Hey guys, this is David Kwan here, here to talk about another one of those next-gen trends. I'm putting that in quotes because it's kind of a misnomer. It's not technically a next-gen trend. It's just a trend that I see happening, especially as I've seen all these press conferences and all these games that were showcased in this year's E3. I think the beginning of this trend really was last year when Nintendo revealed its Wii U new console, because Wii U itself is the concept. The controller is part controller and part tablet, and in a way it's like the Nintendo DS, but on the big screen, and with the controller as the second screen. This concept of using, developers are trying right now to somehow implement tablets and smartphones into the gaming experience, and creating companion apps on the tablet, on the smartphone, mostly the tablet. Because tablet has a much bigger screen and it's much more capable. And it's much more suitable for this type of thing. So there is this trend where developers and game makers are trying to make it so that there is an additional experience to be had in while gaming on the tablet. It's an interesting concept. I really appreciate the fact that developers are trying to be innovative and trying to implement new things into the gaming experience. I at least appreciate that. I'm just not sold on it. I just don't think it'll be that big of a thing. It's kind of a gimmicky thing, you know. If I want to play Watch Dogs, I want to play Watch Dogs. Why do I want to be the guy that has a tablet that taps on the screen to aid the player that is playing Watch Dogs? And if I'm tapping the screen, it's like, oh, let me stop the traffic for you there. Tap on the screen on the map, stop the traffic. The guy passes through, helping the guy. It's a cool, neat idea if I'm playing Watch Dogs and I have a friend who just sucks at video games. Because I do. My best friend is actually like that. He is not really good at video games, and he's not a gamer. But he sometimes likes to watch me play and stuff, and we talk while I'm playing. That has happened before. So with a friend like that, he doesn't even have a smartphone. He's a late adopter to technology. But let's say he has a tablet, okay? And with that tablet, he helps me out as I'm playing the game. That kind of cooperative experience, local cooperative experience, pretty cool. I think that would be a neat idea. But as a separate thing for me, the tablet, I don't even have a tablet. So watching these press conferences for me and this year's E3 was just like, okay, stop rubbing it in, developers. Because developers are like, hey, David, you know, every time, every press conference, every game they showcase, it's just like they have this tablet. They're doing something on this tablet. One guy is, they have like multiple people on stage. One person is playing the game. It's like a racing game. One person is racing the car. Another person is with the controller racing against this other guy. And then there's this guy with the tablet. And he's tapping stuff. And whatever he's tapping, you know, it affects the game that they're playing. But if they're just tapping stuff on the map of the game, of the match, like, okay, that's cool that you get to help someone out. I guess the appeal is that if you finish your game in your living room and you're out there and you're taking a bus ride or you're in the subway train and you want to help your friend out, I mean, you need Wi-Fi, first of all, but so I don't even know how that's going to work. But if you have a cellular data plan, you know, you can take out the companion app and help your friends as they're playing their games. Neat idea, but really, I'm not sold on it. Like, if I'm out and I want to play a game, I'm not going to do that. I'd rather play an actual game on my iPhone, or I'll take my 3DS and play a 3DS game, or I might just read a book. I don't need to take this game all the time, everywhere, all the time. I'm not, like, really that addicted to gaming, you know. But it is an interesting concept. I just think The trick is to make this companion app be meaningful and impactful to the gaming match that you're influencing. That's one thing. But the second thing, and this is probably the most important thing itself, the experience itself, using the tablet itself, must be fun. And I feel like a lot of these companion apps for all these games, and it's going to be all these games, seriously, even Metal Gear Solid 5 is going to try to do this companion app type of deal and use smart glass. And that's why Kojima mentioned smart glass in the Microsoft conference, because he's going to do that. Every game is going to do that. It's like Titanfall, Metal Gear Solid 5, The Crew, Watch Dogs, Battlefield 4. All these games are going to have companion apps, but a lot of them just don't seem fun. Like, I don't see the point in it other than this local cooperative situation that I mentioned. I guess the only positive reaction I've heard from journalists about companion apps is with Tom Clancy's The Division. I don't know how that works. You really need to learn more about it and watch more on that. But this really seems to be the only positive feedback so far from gaming journalists and from the gaming press. But honestly, this companion app idea, I think it really would only be successful on one platform, which is the Nintendo Wii U. Because their system, you don't have to have a separate tablet, or you don't have to put down your controller to have that experience. It's already on there, on the controller. So I think it could work. If there's a developer out there who can do really innovative stuff for the Nintendo Wii U platform, I think it would be an amazing experience. Right now, for that kind of experience, I'm really looking forward to how Pikmin 3 plays out. Because that seems to really utilize the controller, and it actually seems to really enhance the gameplay experience of Pikmin 3. So I really think this companion app trend is happening. It's going to be really prevalent, but I feel like it's going to be like developers trying to shoehorn this tablet and smartphone to the gamers and be like, hey, this really is cool. Trust us. It's really cool. And most of the time, we're going to be probably like, I'd rather play my game. No thanks. I don't know. Tell me what you guys think. What do you think about this trend about using tablets and smartphones with your gaming experience? Are you guys excited? Do you guys not care? Or are you guys actually dreading the thing that developers are going to spend so much money and resources to try to make this happen with their gaming experiences? Tell me what you think. Anyway, I hope you guys enjoyed. Have a great day. Cheers.